friends, welcome back YouTube, welcome to my life. I am currently in the kitchen. It is a Monday night. I figured I would start this video tonight while I'm doing a little food prep because this video is going to be all about travel tips when you're traveling with food. So I am flying across the country on Wednesday morning at like 5:45 a.m. So I'm trying to get all of my like food prep and you know just think like food packed by like I'm just trying to get it finished by tomorrow early in the evening. That way I can go to bed early since I have a really early flight to catch. So I get asked all the time like what are my hacks for traveling with food. I still find that a lot of people don't realize that you can pretty much travel with anything besides liquid, and peanut butter is considered a liquid. So in this video, I'm gonna just take you guys through what I'm gonna pack, some of my travel hacks, and no, I am not on prep, disclaimer. And so I know I'm gonna get people that may ask like, why do you pack all this food when you travel if you're really not on prep? And the answer is, you know, I do still track my macros in my improvement season. It's not just a free for all, but the biggest thing is honestly, if I'm being completely honest, I don't like to spend an arm and a leg on food when I don't have to. So of course, I'm gonna probably eat out a couple times, but I don't want to be buying all of my meals. I eat a lot of food. So that would be pretty expensive. And I'd rather, you know, spend my money on other things. Plus, I just feel really good when I'm eating, you know, clean, simple foods that I'm used to. When I eat out all the time for every meal, like that just doesn't make me feel great because my body is not used to that. So what I'm doing right now is I am in the kitchen. I've got some stuff already packed. I'm gonna go through that stuff with you guys. But what I'm doing right now is I'm actually preparing some omelets. So I know that sounds weird, but omelets are actually really easy to just make, put in a baggie, and like they're very mess free if you just need a quick source of protein while you're traveling. You know, it's easier than doing hard boiled eggs or scrambled eggs. Omelets are so easy. Honestly, you don't even need a utensil to enjoy them. So that is what I'm doing right now. I'm gonna show you guys a ton of different hacks, walk through some TSA guidelines in this video because I actually will not be checking a bag. So all of the stuff I'm bringing with me will have to go through airport security. So stay tuned. I hope this video is helpful for you guys and I will see you in the next clip. Okay, you guys. So travel hack number one. In the last clip you saw, I was making these little omelets. Well, this sad guy, he didn't quite make it. He's just kind of a scramble at this point, but it's still the same thing, whatever. These two are omelets. So what I do is my hack number one for traveling with food is using baggies. Now, the reason I like to use baggies is A, they save space. Rather than taking Tupperware, right? Because Tupperware is great, but it does take up more space. So if you want to pack a lot of food, Tupperware is not always going to be ideal. And two, with baggies, you can just throw them away when you're done. Tupperware, you have to deal with like the dirty Tupperware, right? And when you're traveling, you're usually not going to have access to a sink that you're going to want to wash it out with, right? So that is why I love traveling with baggies. So that is what I put, you know, all of my prepped food in. I actually have some chicken too that I have in the freezer right now, but I cooked it the other day. I put it in a baggie, probably like 10 ounces worth, honestly, maybe a little less. That's in a baggie. I'm gonna take that, but I have my little omelets and then I have my chicken. So those are some like protein sources that I had to prep. So I'm gonna show you guys some of the other easy things that I'm taking with me on the plane. And when I say easy, some of the things I'm going to show you guys next are things that you do not have to prep. So I'm going to show you guys those here in the next clip. Okay, so as promised, I'm going to show you guys some easy things that I am bringing with me on the plane. Again, going back to what I said in the first clip, I know I'm not on prep, but I do still like to travel with food because A, I mean, I feel like it's sometimes a stressor, especially when you're traveling through an airport to like find time to stop and get food. Like you just never know with flights, right? And the last thing I want is to be without food. You know, bodybuilder problems. And then second off, I am all about saving money where I can. And when I travel, like the food is not a huge part for me. I mean, yes, I'll enjoy a meal or two out, but like, you know, the food is not, I'm a foodie, but I'm also like, I travel for more so the experience and getting to see things. Food is not like something that I'm crazy about on trips, right? So I like to save some money where I can, not to say I'm not gonna eat out while I'm there, but if I can have at least like half, maybe even like 3/4 of my meals, you know, of stuff I pack, that would be awesome and save me a good amount of money, especially since I'm going to California and From what I hear, it's pretty expensive there. So I'm gonna show you guys some easy things that you can pack with you. And again, I am taking all of this on a carry-on. All of this can go through airport security. As long as I do not take liquids, they will not confiscate any of it from me. Now they may like stop me in security and look through things, but they're never gonna confiscate food. Trust me, I have traveled with tilapia. I've traveled with pretty much everything, even veggies, and they'll let you through. They may stop and search you, but they're not going to confiscate it from you unless it's a liquid. Okay, so I guess with that being said, I did mention the liquid. So with that being said, peanut butter is considered a liquid. So sad tears, I can't bring a whole jar of peanut butter, but I got the next best thing. And I actually have these from like these samples from demos that I've been to, or not demos, expos. So I have these peanut butter pouches, these peanut butter, they're like single serve peanut butters. And I can take these because they're below like the limit. I think it's what, like 3 ounces or something that you have to be below for liquids so they can go through security. So I have my peanut butter pouches. So that's first and foremost. Secondly, of course I am bringing my instant oats. Bringing these packets, and then I also have a different brand of oats that I put some more oats in this baggie. I'd much rather prefer to have more than I need than to run out of food. So I have my oats, very easy thing to just make in the hotel room. Even if I don't have a microwave, you can always still brew hot water in the coffee maker, Keurig, and then just let it steep in like a serving of oats, and it actually turns into oatmeal. So I have my oats. Another thing I am bringing is going to be protein powder. Of course, this is pretty much a given when you're traveling, in my opinion. Easy way to get in protein. If you guys know me, I think I've showed it in a couple of videos on my channel. I love making protein pudding. So essentially what I'll do in a hotel room is I'll add like a scoop of protein powder. I'll just add a little water. I'll stir it up until it's like a paste. And sometimes I'll just eat it like that. You can use it as a spread for rice cakes if you want, but you can ultimately just eat it like that too. So protein powder, and PE Science actually makes these cute little 5-serving bags. And I find that they're perfect to travel with because I don't wanna travel with a whole tub of protein. And then I also do not wanna put it in baggies, but this is a really good like traveling protein bag. So I've got this. Okay, I have a pouch of tuna, because easy protein if I need it. And this one's actually really cute. It has a little spoon on the top. So I'm just gonna make sure I do not eat this on the plane because I don't think my neighbor would like that. And then, okay, I probably need to get like one or two more at the store. But this is a great time. Traveling is when I will eat protein bars. Usually I don't eat a lot of protein bars regularly, but I find that they're super easy to travel with. So I have an Outright bar. I find that I sometimes have a tendency to undereat on accident when I'm traveling. So protein bars are super easy for me to just get in something quick. And like an Outright bar has 14 fat, 25 carb, 15 protein. So like I would not probably eat this whole thing in one sitting on any other day when I'm home, but when I'm traveling, it's not a bad option. I also got this Legendary Foods like little pastry from the Olympia, and I haven't tried it yet because again, I don't tend to eat a lot of these like snacks regularly, but I'm gonna take it just in case because I don't know. Again, it's kind of similar like macro profile to a protein bar. Okay, next thing in this little baggie I have is nuts. Just, you know, another fat option. I do find that I struggle to hit fats when I am traveling, so I do always like to make sure that I have some fats. That's why the omelets that I made sure to leave the yolk in, some of the eggs, and I have my peanut butter, and I have my nuts. So yeah, so those are some of the easy things I am traveling with. Just have them in a baggie. I'm gonna put them either in my backpack that I'm carrying on or my little suitcase. I'm not sure which yet, but those are some easy options that I like to travel with. You know, the oats, the protein powder, the little peanut butter pouches. Normally, if I was actually checking my luggage, I would take a full jar of peanut butter and just put it in my my checked bag. But since I am actually not checking any bags and going through security, I have to make sure that I do not bring a whole jar of peanut butter or else it will get confiscated and that would be sad. So I'm gonna show you guys some more tips. I'm gonna show you guys how I'm gonna pack this stuff, show you a couple more things I'm actually prepping that's gonna have to go in a cooler. And yeah, so hopefully you guys are learning something so far and you are enjoying this video. Okay, as promised, I'm gonna show you guys how I pack my items, my food items, and then I'm also gonna show you a couple things that I didn't show you in the previous clip. So I forgot I had these Eat Me Guilt-Free Protein Tortillas. They've been in my freezer, and they're really good. They actually have 9 grams of protein, 14 grams of carbs and not too much fat at all, 3 grams of fat, but it's perfect to travel with. I am going to show you guys a couple of like meals that I could potentially prepare in my hotel room with some of the stuff I'm bringing. So these will be a component of that because you guys saw that I made the little omelets, and I think that honestly it'd be so easy to just take one of these tortillas, wrap it up in the egg omelet, and it's like essentially my own little breakfast wrap, right? So I'm going to bring these. I'm going to put them in a baggie so I don't have to travel with this big thing. Couple of other things. I'm bringing some Crystal Light because I do like to enjoy this in my water. I'm kind of a dork, and I'm bringing a few different seasonings. So I am bringing my salt because I love salt, and then bringing some cinnamon because I do like putting cinnamon on my oats, and I don't like to live without it, and it's not something that I want to buy. I don't want to buy these two things or have to worry about buying them, you know, when I'm there. I hate, you know, traveling and having bland food, so I like to try at least and bring like I try to at least bring like a seasoning. Another thing too that you can do, and sometimes shameless plug, I will do this in the airport, if you stop by like a little kiosk at one of the little restaurants, they'll have like little packets of mustard or hot sauce and plastic silverware. I always hit that up, especially for plastic silverware. I'll go to the airport. If I pass one of those little kiosks, I'll grab some plastic silverware. I'll grab little packets of mustard, hot sauce, whatever they have for my food. Another thing I have in that I'm bringing is this liquid stevia. So of course I know I'm going to be getting probably coffee. And I do like to bring my own liquid stevia. I like this one. It's just from Walmart. So I'll add this to like my Starbucks and my coffee. But this is what I'm essentially using to package my food that needs to stay cold. So I do not have my cold food laid out, but the cold food that I am bringing, as I showed you guys previously, would be the, I did prepare some chicken, and then I have some eggs, or some of those egg omelets, right? Now I'm also probably going to prep some rice just to have another carb source on hand if I need it. So what I'll do is I will, this is a pretty small little like lunch bag, I'll put an ice pack or two in there, frozen in the morning before I leave, and I will put my chicken, my eggs, the stuff that needs to stay cold in this, right? And I will probably just put this in my, slide it into my little backpack. But as long as your ice packs are frozen, you can absolutely take them through TSA. The only thing to be careful with is if you are going to be traveling, you know, with food that has to stay cold, make sure that your ice packs are not melted. They can potentially take your ice packs if they are melted. I've never had them like take my ice packs or look at my ice packs. Granted, I try to always make sure my ice packs are frozen and cold. So I'm gonna slide a couple of ice packs in here in the morning with my frozen or cold food, and then I'll just slide this into my backpack and travel with it so my stuff stays cold. And honestly, I've done this before, and the stuff will stay cold if you really put some good ice packs in there for, I mean, you almost the whole day, right? Like I've traveled where I've taken this and started with it super early in the morning and haven't actually taken the food out until like late in the evening, and it's actually still cold. So as long as you're packing in some ice packs, you don't have to worry about your food staying cold. One other thing that I did think of, if you are somebody who was like, oh, I'm gonna try and travel with yogurt, just a random thought that came to my mind, TSA may potentially consider that a liquid, so I would definitely not try and bring yogurt through if that was something you were just thinking about. But this is how essentially I will put my cold food, or how I will take it, how it will stay cold. So these are just some little last minute things I wanted to show you guys before I show you and give you guys a couple more tips to wrap up this video. Okay, so I wanted to sit down and end this video really quickly. Hope it wasn't super boring. I hope it was really helpful. But I wanted to give you guys a couple more tips. And my first tip being, okay, so I'm traveling through an airport tomorrow, right? And if you have not gathered by watching the rest of this video or the previous parts of this video, I am all about saving money, and I really do not want to spend $5 on a water bottle at the airport. So I always bring my blender bottle, my shaker cup, through security with me. Obviously I bring it through empty, and then most airports nowadays will have the little, not water fountain, but whatever you want to call it, like the water spout. You guys know what I'm talking about. But I will bring this through, that way I can just fill up my water for free. But that is a hack. And then I did want to just talk and tell you guys a few of my little like go-to hotel meals that are really easy to prepare when I'm in a hotel. So based off of the things you guys saw that I'm bringing, I did forget to show you, I am bringing rice cakes. They're in my suitcase. They kind of take up a lot of room, but I don't care. I'm bringing them. But a couple of different ideas that, you know, I'm gonna give you guys for hotel meal options. So the first thing being, I brought my instant oatmeal packets, and I told you it's really easy to just make oatmeal in your hotel room, even if you don't have a microwave. Just brew hot water in a coffee maker and put it on top of your oats and stir it up and let it sit for a few minutes, and it will turn into oatmeal. So the first meal that I always like to make is oatmeal for my carbs, and then usually I'll add in a scoop of protein and then add some nut butter, and then I've got protein, carbs, and fat. Boom, right there, easy hotel meal. The next thing is, you know, you saw that I am traveling with my chicken, so I have chicken, and I can easily throw some salt, some seasoning on that, and pair it with a carb source, right? So I have, I'm bringing rice cakes. I'm also going to prepare some rice. Rice is really easy to just prepare, throw in a baggie and travel with, so I could easily have some chicken and some rice. I can also do, you know, I have those wraps that I showed you guys that I'm bringing. So you could easily bring a wrap to a hotel. Doesn't have to be the wraps I showed you, but you could easily bring a wrap. And then I have those little omelets prepared, and I can easily just wrap up an omelet in a wrap, and it's my own little makeshift like breakfast wrap, right? So that's something. And then protein bars are always really easy options as well. You can do a lot with the protein powder. As I mentioned before, one of my favorite things to do is I just like to add a scoop of protein powder in a cup, put a little water in it, stir it up until it's like a sludge. And then what you can do is you can actually top that on rice cakes if you want, or you can just enjoy it as like protein pudding. You can add peanut butter to it if you so choose. Yeah, so those are some of my go-to like hotel meal options. As I mentioned, I always like to come prepared. I would much rather bring more food than I need, because at the end of the day, I can either A, throw it away, or I can just travel back home with it. But moral of the story too, if you get anything from this video, is make sure you do not take a tub of peanut butter through TSA. They will confiscate it, so you do have to make sure that you just take the little individual squeeze pouches through TSA so that you can get through with it. But I always like to travel with a couple protein sources, a couple carb sources, and a couple fat sources. That way I have my bases covered. I don't have to stress about finding a grocery store when I get there. And I don't know about you guys, but I do enjoy having food in my hotel room, even if I am eating out. Sometimes, you know, I get hungry and I don't want to have to worry about, you know, finding some place to go and get food, right? So that's why I do travel with food. Even though I'm not on prep, I'm in my improvement season. As I said in the beginning of this video, I am one of those people, I don't like to eat out every meal, right? My body is not used to that. So for me to go from always preparing my own food to going on a vacation or a trip and literally eating out for every meal, my digestion would hate me. My stomach would hate me, and I do not want to do that. So I hope this video was helpful for you guys. I'm gonna wrap it up here, but I am going to be doing a whole travel vlog. I'm gonna make that a separate video because I didn't want this video to be too lengthy. So stay tuned for that. Please like this video, share it if it was helpful, comment below if you have any travel hacks of your own, and if you guys have watched this far, thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.